night. And they could get me even tighter and tighter until someday I swear I hear angels play. Goodness, is it really real? It would take a child to know the way I feel. Oh my, floating in the blue. I could take the credit, but it's thanks to you.
Welcome aboard.
Oh, yeah, Hank Jr., what did you think about Obama? No.
Welcome to Keeping Country Strong.
Hey, listen, we got everything here tonight.
We got a great show.
We got one of the best rappers in Jersey here. Timmy Grins.
In the country.
New Jersey.
It's just Jersey. Yeah. You're limiting the guy.
Global, bro.
That's right.
Global. Kilimanjaro next year.
Kilimanjaro.
He'll go to a mountaintop just to prove it. I know.
That's right. You're going
to climb Mount Kilimanjaro just to prove it.
That's great.
And then we got the Snake Man over here.
Jerry the Snake Man. Welcome aboard.
And we got Joe from Pocono Hot Dogs.
Pocono Hot Dogs drove all the way out from the Poconos.
Well, I don't know how you was a cop. What street am I on? I get to see that now.
Hey, I tell you, I had a lot of help.
I bet.
38,000 other fellow officers, buddy.
I had a magnet on the motor. Just took you right to it.
Biggest part of the day was signing out.
I bet.
Get out of the city as quick as possible.
Well, let's go see what these guys got. Then we'll show Timmy stuff. He's got some stuff going. We'll go to Joe first. And what are you doing here tonight anyway?
I don't know. I met Benzee down on 57th Street a couple years back. He gave me a ticket on my cart, and I ended up moving.
Oh, that figures another guy with a ticket.
Yeah.
A little out of the area. I wouldn't be surprised.
They're glad you're out of the area.
Yeah, but we just came up, make you guys some hot dogs, some of the famous Pocono hot dogs. We do a lot of catering in the Pocono area, and our hot dogs are a specialty.
You guys go to Camel Beach?
Yeah, but we don't let the dogs go in the water.
Gotcha.
Oh, brother.
Big on Facebook, Pocono Hot Dogs.
Oh, we push Facebook, the heck
on
Facebook.
One of our guys on Facebook. Unbelievable.
And I know you do the hot dog trips.
Yeah, we do the hot dog tours.
Hey, listen,
we can never make it out to Pennsylvania.
He was telling me maybe we can set a deal up with him.
Yeah, we're mobile. We'll make it to you.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
He could do a mobile thing for our bus trips, where the bus would pull off and we could all have hot dogs.
Yeah, because you're not far from, because we do our trips to Mount Airy. That would work.
Well, that's what he said. Maybe we could do that and set that up. That'd be great.
That's a great idea.
Give us a deal on the hot dogs, so that'd be great.
Everybody watching us, Sunday, November 6th, we're going to Mount Airy, sold out.
Sold out.
Sold out.
Sold out.
Sold out trip.
Sold out.
I got about 15 people on a waiting list. The next one's going to be December 4th. I set it up.
December 4th.
Confirmed. December 4th, same deal. Mount Airy Casino. We're leaving from Monroe, Middletown, and Port Jervis. Give us a call. Get us on Facebook, and we'll get you on board. But right now, we're sold out for November 6th. So.
Hey, you know what we could do? Now, we got the Snake Man here.
He's
a pro snake. Maybe we can get the snakes to get loose on the bus. We can make a movie out of this. They did it on the airplane, right?
They did, right?
Yeah.
Have him wrestle with one of the big snakes? That'd be great.
Well, that
be your last trip.
That's right.
Yeah.
Have you done stuff with that on TV, like with the people call you TV shows to advise on certain snakes?
We get people interested in TV shows. None of them ever actually worked out because you got to have a commitment.
Yeah.
We have regular jobs as well, so we can't.
Oh, bread and butter, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, we know that, bread and butter. It's the same with the band business, you know.
Yeah, and you could get a call. They want you to fly out to California for 2 weeks or something. And like, how do you leave your regular job, right?
Well, we did have one lady contact us on our website, and she wanted a snow and a show. And I told my wife, I said, well, she's from Florida. And I said, you want a free trip to Florida? So when I told the lady, I said, as long as you're willing to pay all the expenses, we're willing to go.
Sure.
She didn't realize she was contacting us in New York, though. She thought we were local to Florida.
Oh.
Because it said Orange County, and she thought it was Orange County in Florida, not New York.
That's right. You got Orange County in Florida, California, and New York.
It's amazing, because they probably got tons of snakes and stuff down there.
Oh, they do, and that's why up here in North, it's more popular. I mean, we do a lot of shows, because we do have a lot of snakes up here, but not as many as they do down there all the time. You know, so down there, it's not as big of a deal like in Texas or whatever. You know, you see a rattlesnake all the time in your backyard.
Well, Joe here is gonna. He's not making rattlesnake stew or nothing, but he's gonna. Yeah, he's gonna make me one of his Texas wieners. He says he makes the best hot dogs around. Did you ever have any yet?
This is what I understand. No, but we're gonna have the first ones tonight.
Yeah. So the crew, everybody. So all you people didn't come to the show. Too bad. But he's got the stove. He's over there cooking away, and we got the snake man here and the. Too bad we couldn't do that on the bus. I think that'd be a great idea. Get them snakes crawling all over the bus.
The only problem we're dealing with, we got a lot of senior citizens on the bus.
That's okay.
You know, and the hearts might not be there. I don't want anybody with their bad tickers.
Snakes should be okay.
Yeah.
That's bad publicity, Carl, if you lose somebody on the bus because snakes crawling underneath.
Listen,
you know
we'll
what I mean?
Them,
that's not good publicity.
If you don't buy a hot dog, then you're not. We're going to let the snakes loose.
That's a good idea.
Yeah. See, he likes that, right?
Yeah.
Oh, brother. So where do you do all your...
We've been on ski slopes. We do a lot of festivals in the Pocono area. Just a lot of places. Thornhurst Country Club. We do a lot of golf tournaments, things like that.
Well, hopefully we get both of you actually and Tim too. We have a telethon November 12th, and you'll see this. So we're looking for people to donate money to help us get new equipment, which we definitely need here. This stuff's falling apart.
Well, we'll donate some equipment so you can get some money.
Oh, there you go.
There you go. Now, you do a lot of these ski slopes in the winter. What's it like? You have to stand out in the cold for 5-6 hours. You got the heaters going. You got to set it up, right?
The cart stays pretty hot. Yeah. Underneath the umbrella. We've done a lot of snowmobile trails, too, on Pinchon Trail down in Thunderhurst.
Oh, what's it like having somebody pulling up in skis and like, give me two dogs? That's got to be wild. Right.
Oh yeah, sure. Why not?
Do you have a spot where you usually, or you just travel all over?
I'll travel all over. I do a lot of different backyard parties. We did a World Series party the other night, last night.
That makes sense.
Well, poor Jervis does a lot of different things during the summer. He could be tied right into that.
Sure, why not?
And they have a little concert series during the summer.
Well,
and
the festivals you do. This is a whole other market for you, really.
How many carts you have?
Three.
Three carts, huh?
Nice.
That's a nice.
Why'd you get into hot dogs?
Because
he likes them.
I don't know. I like hot dogs.
Yeah, no, sure.
I've always been a chef, and I was just a way out of the kitchen and my own hours and things.
Good for you.
Oh, that's great, man.
Good for you.
Everybody loves hot dogs. Forget about it.
Hey, on that.
Timmy, you got something going on.
Oh, man.
You got a concert coming up, right?
Concert. November 4th at the Chance Theater in Poughkeepsie.
Friday night.
Oh, the Chance.
That's a big venue.
Yeah. Oh, it's a pretty big spot. Yeah. I'm playing with, you guys remember the Quimby Mountain Band?
Yeah, we had them on the show.
It came through, right? Yeah. We played on the show.
That was
great.
Right? Fantastic.
Very good band.
So it's me, the Quimby Mountain Band, and then the Fear Nuttin Band. The Fear Nuttin Band, they're out of Springfield,
Mass. Where do you get these names from?
It's like a reggae rock kind of thing, right?
Okay.
That's so a cool, flyer they got up there on the TV.
Yeah, I like that one, right?
Made that up right before the show.
That is my handwriting.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, that is my handwriting. So there you
I
can
like
see
these artists that just come right on in. Here's my flyer for the night.
You like that, right?
Yeah, but Timmy's cool because Timmy... It gives himself third billing. I mean, he's a top guy, you know
I'm
what
saying.
I mean? And you put the Fear Nuttin Band first, and then the Quimby Mountain Band, and then you.
Look everybody out.
That's
man.
Cool.
You know what I mean?
And
you know,
actually,
my lady,
he's
got
most
a big
people putting the flyer
guy,
together would have put their name first.
Well, you know,
right?
You know, I mean, maybe.
You're the main guy.
Maybe, you know, I just
I
like to
so.
Kind of be.
He actually has a following. We got two people come out.
You know? Yeah, I'm saying. Yeah, it should be a great show. It really should. It should be a good time, man. It'd be like a real party vibe. You know what I mean? Because everybody that's playing brings a real fun enthusiasm to the mix.
And your CD is really cool.
Thank you, man. I appreciate that.
The Grimm's Land Collection.
The Lamb and Grimm's Collection.
Lamb and Grimm's Collection.
Yep.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, it's actually doing very well.
You promised me a CD, too. So.
Oh, I got one for you. No problem, man. Yeah, 100%.
Oh, don't forget Joe here. He wants one, too.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I definitely...
He's got a good video. You got to see his show. He's got a good video.
It's really good. It's good music.
Yeah, stuff that got me to the Oprah Winfrey Show last year.
Yeah.
Not quite as big as Keepin' Country Strong, man, but I'm working on it.
Plus, what I got to tell you...
Oprah's done. Oprah's off the air. We're still on the air.
Numero uno.
She took her money and ran, even though she needed a train to take it.
She ran. Yeah.
Walk away.
Yeah.
But I got to tell you about Tim. I listen to his stuff, and not that I'm into rap, but he doesn't use all that foul language and stuff in it, which is unique, I think, anyway. You know, most of it, you know.
Yeah, I'm just a good rapper, man.
Yeah, I like
you know, I was never into rap music till I heard this.
There you go,
CD.
Man. Yeah, so I'm trying to blaze really, some new trails, man.
Go
some
yeah, all them people out in Bullville. He knows what this guy's about.
Yeah, oh, I got to mention Bullville. Bullville.
The chance.
Bullville.
8 p.m.?
What a place for him. Bullville.
Doors open about 8 o'clock, yeah.
It's always
yeah.
throwing the ball. Bullville. He moved them right into the...
Which is right next to Bloomingburg, New York, where Jerry the Snake Man's from.
Wow.
Did you know that?
No, I just... Okay. He just told...
We don't acknowledge that, though.
Oh, okay.
Don't acknowledge it.
Want to keep that private?
He's at Quickway Diner.
Top secret.
He's at Quickway Diner, too, every day. he's taking it from Teak and V. He loves their coffee.
Has to slither out of town once in a while.
Yeah, but I met him a long time ago, Jerry, at a redneck party, right? It was like 400 or 500 people.
Oh, what were you doing at a redneck party?
Yeah, it was great, man. And he had
hard
the snakes.
I can't believe that.
I did all
here.
Kinds of stuff. We had a great
there.
Time. Yeah. No. We were the only band. It was great.
Oh, that's what's
it
up
was a there. Joke. It started out as a joke. I used to do a morning program with Redneck Decker.
Right.
And we used to promote the Carl Richard Band, well, because Carl was very good about giving CDs and hats and everything.
Yeah, say another giveaway. They love that
give
crap.
Us stuff, we'll promote you all over the place. We just made a joke about having a redneck festival. People took us seriously. Within 2 weeks, we had the whole thing planned. Vendors.
Wow.
Carl
Livingston
was there,
Manor.
Was there.
It was packed.
Wow. I don't doubt it, man. I don't doubt it.
So we were, I'm a hillbilly anyway. Redneck for a day. We had steaks crawling around. It was great.
Man, I'm saying, man. That sounds like a good time.
So you missed
man.
Some of that stuff.
I'm saying. I run with a band called the Quimby Mountain Band.
Those guys
you know
are good.
I mean? It's like, you know, I'm down, man.
They got their
I'm
own
down.
School bus, which is
they
cool.
got their own school bus.
Yeah, I remember yeah. that. When they were here, they parked it out front.
Yeah, that baby's leaking oil, I got to tell you. There was a puddle God. Under like somebody.
Was it? I don't think that's
yeah, like somebody
thing,
shot it in the ribs or something.
As long as it runs, that's the main thing.
So we're going to get you guys to go on over, and you keep on cooking, and we'll take pictures of you, and we're going to talk to Timmy a little bit, and then we'll come on over, and we'll bring Benzie over, and we can take care of him with the snakes, and we'll just go back and forth, have some fun.
All right.
So thanks for coming down to the
Benzie
show. We'll be talking
right.
to you anyway.
I'm the guinea pig today.
Snake huh? bait.
Snake bait.
Snake bait.
He is always a setup guy. We go, you know.
I got to say, last week's show... was fantastic. Thank you very much to Carl and the staff here at Keeping Country Strong.
Oh, Barry
Strong.
Really. Barry really made
Barry,
it.
Barry, thank you very much, Barry.
He got a host one of Squeaky for his birthday. That was great.
Main production guys. Fever? I got the. I should have brought the keys. I got the keys to Bullville.
Wow.
In a box, dude.
Yeah, we wow. gave him the key.
Yeah, happy birthday, man.
I key to Bullville.
Thank you. It's unbelievable. And I was in the TC Teak and V, the Quickway Diner. Last week, but they weren't there.
And they say you're full of bull. I know.
You know, I had the key with me because I wanted to show Teak and V the key.
Did you buy one of my tapes while you were in there?
What, the eight-tracks?
Cassettes.
Oh, cassettes.
Let's not go back too far. Eight-tracks.
He's got the cassettes.
I dubbed the tape, actually.
He's got the cassettes sitting in the window. It's got to be from, like, 1988.
Well, he made 500.
Serious cassettes.
That's awesome.
He made 500 cassettes and 1,000 CDs, but they don't restock them. They go so fast. Nobody buys
he's
tapes
gotta
no more.
He's got to be figuring that somebody from, like, the city's going to pop in one day.
Well, his
like,
deal...
to recycle them or something. Yeah. Says, how many you got? 200? Give them all.
Well, his deal you know his deal mean? Really was... I did a commercial for him, and then he said to me, listen, I'll pay for your CDs, $3,500 for the album that I did.
Wow.
I says, well, what do you want? He goes, all I want is our picture on it. So on the CD in the middle, it's Teak and V in the middle of our CD.
Yeah. Wow.
Take it from Teak, take it from V. Carl Richards' music is for you and for me.
Ah, I like it, man.
And I played somebody jokes with the guy doing the commercial. The guy was doing the commercial that I know. His name's Carl, too.
Yeah.
And they put a plate in front of me, and the band was, like, around me for the commercial, for the video part.
Yeah.
So he had a roll on there. I took a bite out and put it back. When the guy's walking back, and he's looking in the camera, he goes, something's screwy here. So he comes back, and he goes, don't eat the props. So, because I was taking bites, and so he says, at the end, make sure you yell yeehaw. So I took a big mouthful of corn. He didn't know it.
No.
So I'm just faking like I'm singing.
Yeah.
So I got yeehaw, like spit the corn all over. He goes, you know, you're crazy, hillbilly. Come on.
We
had a lot of fun there.
Oh,
yeah.
It sounds like it. Yeah. I got to get up to the Quickway Diner, man.
They got the best soup on the planet.
I got to get up there. They're the coffee.
They're looking to do another commercial. We're looking to.
And tonight's show, we got
cool.
We're gonna do three cuts too from Larry Chance. And the Earls, it's Larry's birthday. Great guy, and he still sings
Happy
great.
Happy birthday, Larry.
You know, so that'll be on here soon. So who are we going to go see first? We're going to go. He's cooking hot dogs over there. You want to go see the Snake Man
Let's
first?
Let's do Jerry the Snake Man.
All right, come on. We're all going to walk over and meet the Snake Man.
Where's Snake Man?
Come on, buddy.
Snake snack.
Come on, man. Get over to the snake table. Right in corner three here, we got the snake.
All right. Live TV right here, baby.
Benzie's the one we're after, right? You said?
What'd you tell him that for? That was supposed to be a trick.
Oh, he knew right away. As soon as I met him, he says, I'm the fall guy here. You know?
All right, take care of
him. I'm the fall guy. Yeah, I know. Says, I even got it in writing. You know, I saved that email. I want you to know.
By the way, these aren't poisonous.
We'll
find
out. What
are you backing up for?
This is
well,
the one you actually put
this
on
ahead
your,
of time.
You actually put this one on your Facebook page.
Okay.
So as you can see here, this is an Amazon treat boy. You can see he's not very happy.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I like about him.
Yeah, don't reach in there, Benzie, for God's sake.
No, you don't have to worry. They got a very long strike. They'll nag it from across the room. So. And they're considered face biters, so usually they'll go right after your face.
You can't hurt Benzie. Go get him.
These guys are from the Amazon. They're really cool. One of the things about these guys that's really neat is
his face is red.
They can actually spend their entire life without touching the ground. They bear live babies when they're born. They stay in the trees. As you see, he's got a prehensile tail. He's got a good hold around my hand here. So he holds himself up onto the branches. He'll hold himself straight out. He'll eat birds, lizards, mice, rodents, whatever will happen to crawl by. They do have heat sensors, so what he's doing now is he's sizing out Benzee, actually.
Yeah, he is.
Keeping an eye on him.
Closer, Benzee.
And if Benzee moves his hand close enough, he will strike at him.
Oh, yeah?
The only reason that these snakes could be a little docile tonight is the simple fact it's a little chilly outside.
Okay.
Right.
So they're a little laid back. Hopefully, they're not going to stay too laid back, though. We got a few... We're going to take out the next time you come and talk to us, the venomous ones. I can guarantee you my water moccasin is not laid back. He don't care how cold it is.
That's
but as you can see this guy here, he's trying to own the stick, which he's about to do.
Wow.
I'll end up with the hook part in a second. He's going to end up toward the top because that's where he's headed. We got another Amazon with us too, which is here. And you'll notice the difference in coloration.
Where's burying them when you need them?
And this guy's headed back now again.
Most of the staff are hidden in the control room right now, folks.
That's right, man. You don't see snakes like this every day.
Me and Carl will do anything for a good TV. Right, Carl?
Well, you will. I'm just the guy.
Well, you're standing over there.
I'm like Jungle Jim. Come on out in the woods there, buddy.
We got one here.
Are you praying for that thing, or you just want to get nipped good?
No, I just want to get his attention.
Did you tell me this is how Johnny Carson became famous, doing this kind of stuff?
I don't know.
I don't. Jesus.
But he had Ed McMahon, so I'm lucky. I got you.
I don't see Ed McMahon getting too involved in this stuff.
Yeah, Ben,
you can hold that stick. Okay, right. We're gonna hold him.
Okay.
All right. Now this guy here again. He's they kind of like you. You must be more warmer than Carl Richards is.
I'm a popular guy. Whoa, hey,
there
whoa.
You go. See, they're face fighters. They come right at your face every time. They go after body heat.
They like us on air personalities.
You'll never say that about Rock.
How you doing?
Hardest part is sometimes actually is getting these guys back into the containers. Obviously,
how many times you got bitten by these things? I know they're not really poisonous.
I don't get bit. Very seldom will you see me get bit.
Well, this is something we should ask before we started handling.
Well, I figured you're the front man. You can just.
Now this is usually the fun part here, getting them back in here. A lot of the kids usually like this better than the show itself. Put them in one side, they pop out the other. Now, again, this guy here, he's probably going to bite, but he's a little cold, so he's...
He's going to bite you. He likes this. How many times have you been bitten, anyway?
Believe it or not, I've been bitten one time by a rattlesnake. Compliments of Redneck Decker.
Oh, figured.
He brought
Redneck.
It back from Texas for me. It bit me. Since that point there, I've never been bit yet.
Really?
That's been almost
there's always
years
a first
ago.
On Keepin' Country Strong.
That's why we're here tonight.
I'm feeling very confident right now.
Oh, this guy's good.
So this guy, we're going to show you a different method, because he's wrapped around the stick pretty good.
Yeah.
So if she hands me my pinning stick, we're going to show you a different way we can deal with him. It's made of soft rubber.
Okay.
So you can get him right behind his head, pin him down. And once you get a snake behind his head, it's pretty much harmless.
I know Timmy
except
can't wait to
for
do that.
The one thing they do, which I hate more than getting bit.
You're going to go up on some mountain out there where they got millions of snakes.
Is they go to the bathroom on you.
Oh, really? And that defense works better than any defense I know so far.
That's the worst kind of steak. They go to the bathroom on you, too.
Oh, well, we're going to have one go to the bathroom on your floor tonight for you.
Great.
We already
Rich,
got him.
Rich, where's your broom?
I got him down there. Trust me. Actually, the kids are very disappointed when he doesn't go to the bathroom.
I can see that.
We tell them, you know, and then they're like, well, watch, go to the, and he doesn't, and the kids get all upset. They're like, why didn't you go to the bathroom?
Hey, well, Joe, you want to come over and join us with the steak?
For a live show, we can't guarantee
you might like hot dogs.
Now, this guy here, hopefully he's going to do what he's supposed to do.
I don't even want to talk about it.
He's going to... We had him doing it earlier.
Is that a diamondback?
Now, this actually here is a bull snake. They're from Texas. And they actually mimic rattlesnakes. If you can notice, the coloration is pretty similar.
Right.
When he gets very aggravated, he will rattle his tail very violently. But what we want him to do right now, and he was doing it earlier, but he probably won't do it again, is if we can get him, he's a little aggravated here.
He's going to hiss at you like your wife does.
Now, she's a little louder.
We're not really looking to get these snakes too aggravated, are we?
Well, this one we are here. We're trying to get him a little aggravated. We want to see a little hiss. Usually grabbed by the tail.
There he goes. Oh, hello.
Give him a little tail action here.
Was that a yee-haw I heard?
Yeah, I think it said, leave me the hell alone. That was what he meant.
There he goes. As you see here. Now, the thing about this, though, is this guy is only bluffing, believe it or not.
Really?
You know, I seen an elephant trainer used to aggravate the elephant. He ain't around
him. If you say so, I believe you, but.
Well, watch. See, now, this guy actually, he just wants to give you a kiss. He's not really upset.
Yeah, give Benzee a kiss.
We can put him right around your shoulders. Watch this. See, he will not hurt you.
Oh, jeez.
He really likes you. He's one of these.
He loves
nice
you, Benzee.
There we go. Now, if we aggravate, pull on his tail.
Well, if you had that Manhattan, nobody'd bother you.
No, just pull on his tail a little.
Really?
Yeah, maybe we get him to hiss here. Strike.
Yeah, yank on his tail. Go ahead.
As you see here, this guy is just a big bluffer. He's not looking to hurt nobody. He just wants you to leave.
You're not supposed to pee on the floor. What's the matter?
I said the snake would go to the bathroom.
I have a change of underwear in the green room, folks.
Good thing we wore our Hawaiian shirts for this.
Oh, yeah.
I was trying to get us some safari hats, but I couldn't find any.
But I love these guys because they are very aggressive appearing. They're actors.
Yeah.
They really don't try to attack you.
What do you think we are?
That's what the show is all about.
And we do run a snake rescue, which we do adopt snakes that people don't want no more. We make sure they're healthy and eating, and then we adopt them back out. This was actually one of those rescues. Believe it or not, the girl gave him up because she said he was nasty.
Really?
Yeah. He's such a sweetheart.
Probably because he hisses.
He hisses and he strikes. Right. Yeah. When he actually strikes at you, though, you can hold your hand right there. He'll fall short every time. He doesn't look to bite you. He really doesn't want to get in a confrontation with you. He just wants you to leave him go.
Okay.
And that's
sounds like
much...
a date I had once. I know Timmy had a date like that, too. Hissed and chased him all around.
Chased him all
around. Remember that? You don't even want to talk.
For a rapper, he's standing pretty far away. I thought these rapper guys are...
You're going
right
to rap about snakes?
Write a song about this.
Okay, then we're going to get one more out.
All right.
Before you guys...
Then we're going to walk over and talk to Joe here. He's cooking hot dogs over there.
You can smell them. They smell great over
now,
there.
Now, we were talking earlier about some of the snakes. Like
he's got gloves on for this one. I'm getting over here.
Yeah, I don't wear gloves too often, but this guy, he has earned,
Benzee, get close.
Earned my respect.
We don't
for
have gloves. What's the story here?
Oh, we talked earlier about different cultures
gloves
worshiping snakes. He was
really?
Yeah, they're not
really
gonna do much good, but go ahead and put them on.
They're not going to do any good.
Yeah.
Okay.
These gloves cost more than my car, actually. I think they're bulletproof as well.
That's good to know, Ben.
You can't get bit through them. You can't get cut through them.
Don't run away now.
Here's a nice thing.
We're co-hosts.
But this snake right here, this is called an African python. Now, keep in mind,
this
is a baby.
Can we put this over your head, Ben?
Oh, these are real. These will help him out a lot.
That's a hot dog guy doing that.
But this guy here...
This is a family show, I won't tell you.
That's right. Keep in mind, this guy is a baby.
Let's not get in the gutter, huh, buddy?
He will get between 20 and 25 feet long.
Really?
Now, picture this guy with this attitude.
That doesn't look like
he doesn't look that bad here.
He don't look that bad. He don't look that bad. Gloves on, I made of steel.
Close to it. This is the one that hopefully will go to the bathroom as well. We get this guy going. There he
goes.
He's an that's a typical African rock python attitude. And he is not joking. As you can see, he will...
Wow.
He gets his teeth slashed on.
I don't want to have him around a hot dog. Holy God.
But, now he's stuck.
You can't go on a date with him, Ben.
Snake's teeth are curved backwards, so when they grab, if you try to yank your hand out of their mouth, you actually will just yank it on farther.
Well, keep him over there so he can yank by you.
But he's also a face biter.
Want to get bit, Tim?
Nah.
Would you like to hold him? You got the gloves.
I don't know. No, I don't think these gloves are going to work.
You're going to kill him in Germany.
These gloves ain't going to work too well.
No, I don't know about that.
They got big snakes there.
But one of the African tribesmen actually was out on his own, was attacked by one of these pythons, but it was a full grown at the time. The guy was wrapped up, had no chance of making it. He actually chewed his way through the snake. When he returned to his village and drug the snake back with him, they threw him out of the village because they actually worshiped these things as gods.
Oh, yeah. Some countries do that.
Harry
anyway.
Saved his life, but yet he lost his village. But these guys are typically always aggressive. But what I like about him the best, though, is that if he can't bite you, normally he will go to the bathroom on you. Again, he's serious.
Where you going, Benzee?
Let's have him.
I know Jerry Cooney.
Well, he was a loser too. So.
Oh! I got to get some better boxing lessons from Jerry Cooney. Jerry's a friend of mine.
You know, sometimes I can't believe he was a cop.
No, we haven't got Carl to hold one yet. You know?
Yeah, Carl. But here, I have gloves for you.
We got the venomous neck, so we'll have him do that.
Should I put this over my nose or what?
Wow.
We sneak him back. And that's the only one, except for the copperhead, I'll take out that I wear the gloves for.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to play with them.
Yeah, either. I didn't think these gloves were going to help.
No, those won't help too much.
All right, we're going to go over to see the hot dog guy, and then you guys get set something.
You got the website and the Facebook page?
Oh, we don't have a Facebook, but we do have a website.
Oh, we put it on our Facebook page, Jerry the Snake Man.
Yep, you put it on yours. We have a website. It's www.jerrythesnakeman.com.
All right. Very simple.
Well, we got to get a microphone over there anyways. So we can actually hear ourselves. So maybe we can drag this one over. I don't know what you're going to do.
Go head over.
Listen to this guy.
Live TV.
I'm going to wrap him up with a snake.
Jerry the Snake Man.
We'll be back.
We'll be back. Thank you very much. This is fantastic. Ready? Right, ready to have some dogs?
Yeah, let's go over to this dog guy now. They won't hear us anyway if we get the microphone over here. That's all right. Here, you go that side. See what we're got going there. Hey, buddy.
How are you?
Thanks for that cheap glove, man.
Got to put another one on now.
All right, here, we got a microphone from somewhere in town. This will pick us up fine. You'll have to be right by it.
Okay. All right, so we're going to make
What are you whipping up here?
We're going to make our soon-to-be famous chili sauce.
Oh,
we're
going to
take
great,
a couple
man.
Of minutes here. That's about it. Start off with some cipollini onions.
Boy, this is turning into a cooking show. This is great. Okay. You're in the right place. I'm cooking with this crowd.
Okay, 1 tablespoon of cumin.
I see Barry came right after this. He didn't like snakes too much.
2 tablespoons of chili powder. We need 1.5 tablespoons of, this is Pocono's secret sauce, 12 spices and herbs. We stole 11 of them from the colonel.
Okay.
And throw in
which
some,
colonel?
Some ground, Colonel Pato. I'm going to put in some ground beef here.
All right.
And this is a puree of heirloom tomato and jalapeno pepper.
Wow.
This is going to be cooking. For all you folks that didn't make the show tonight, we're all going to have hot dogs
right.
here. How about
hot
a hand for this
everybody.
Guy? Don't worry, they're nervous over the snake.
Get these up, And get you guys hooked up here. You wanted a Texas wiener, right?
Yep.
A Texas wiener up for you. And Benzee, we're going to give you the world's largest chili dog.
All right, sounds good.
He needs it after that snake.
Fantastic aroma. Unbelievable.
Oh, boy.
Now that's a hot dog, buddy. Look at that. Holy smokes.
Yeah, you think you have hot dog trips. We bring the hot dogs right here. Are you kidding?
And Texas wiener come right up.
How quickly or how soon were you able to put the recipe together that you came up with this? Did you have to experiment a lot before you came up with the...
I tinkered with it a little bit.
A couple of months or...
Yeah, more like 7-8 minutes.
Really?
Well, you're double
I've heard of establishments taking years before they perfected
well,
what they serve now.
I'm quick. You can ask my wife. She's around here somewhere. I'm
quick. Well, Jerry said if you put the one of them rolls on the copperhead and try to eat it, see what happens.
Oh, yeah.
He'd bite you on the tongue, that'd be it for you.
Get these Texas wieners. These are all black Angus beef, natural casing
hot
dogs.
Oh, brother.
Pocono Hot Dog. If you're friends with us on Facebook, go on Facebook.
Oh, yeah, we got it on Facebook. Anybody likes to join us on Facebook.
If you're watching the show and you're sitting near the computer, go right on there and you can check it out right now.
And we're running their stuff on the show tonight, so you can check these guys out. They come out anywhere.
Anywhere we do World Series parties. We got Super Bowl party coming up.
Wow. That's
fantastic.
Guys rented us out for that, for private events like that. We do football Sundays. There's a lot of Sundays left in Best. We have a few going on, but there's still a few openings.
Okay.
Come right to your house, make you some hot dogs. Whatever stadium you're in, we'll specialize the dog from that stadium. Yeah, and there's your Texas wiener.
There you go, Con.
All right, man. Now that is it.
There you go. And Benzie, here's your world's largest
all
chili
right.
dog.
How come the big guys always get the big ones? That ain't always true. Anyway, boy, that looks
take
good.
Look at that. I am.
Let's see if we can get this all over our Florida shirts. That's right. We're on here eating hot dogs. All you poor people home, you didn't come down to the show. We got hot dogs and snakes.
What brand is
I use a farmland beef. I get them out of a supplier, Schiff's Food Service in Taylor, Pennsylvania.
Okay, very good, very good. I don't think I've ever had anything like this before. This
no,
brand.
I told you, this guy's top of the line, man. What we're going to do is, today's Larry Chance's birthday, so we got some videos of Larry, and we're going to play three songs of Barry, and then we're going to come back with the Snake Man, and we're going to get some everybody to come over and have a hot dog, maybe, and we'll show everybody eating hot dogs. And this gentleman here, these are great.
Great hot dogs.
All right, not a gentleman. Let's go.
So happy birthday to Larry Chance. Larry Chance and the Earls. We're going to play three videos, and we're going to come back to...
As soon as it's ready.
Pocono
I don't know
Hot
it's
Dog
ready
and Jerry the Snake Man.
Are we ready with that yet?
Not yet.
Not yet. I heard from the...
Oh, keep
don't
eating.
Get her mad.
Think the snakes would like a hot dog? Probably not. Do the snakes eat hot dogs?
Never tried them, but they might.
No? I don't know.
We're gonna
we got to feed the humans first.
That's right. What are you pushing everything on the snake for?
I don't know. The snakes were the stars tonight of that,
jeez,
of that episode.
There's always an episode here.
Of that segment. The snake is of that segment. This segment, we got Pocono Hot Dog.
Are we ready yet?
Redeem yourself.
Thank you.
Here we go with Larry Chance and the Earls doing three songs. All right, we can get away from here for a minute.
Yes, sir. Look, look, looking for my baby. Look, look, look at my baby. Looking for my baby. Where, oh, where can she be? Someone hear my plea and send her back to me. Run, 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 run. Here's another one from we like so much. We recorded originally in 1961, and we decided to do it again on a recent CD. It's called Lost Love, and these are the kind of songs we sang without musical accompaniment on the old street corner. The sun won't shine like it used to before. Until you say, darling, that you're mine once more. All of my memories, all of my cares, they are too hard for me to bear. The moon won't glow like it glowed that night. That night when I held you, darling, oh, so tight. We two together, you said it would be. Then you lied, you turned and walked out on me. You took advantage of my faith. faithfulness. You knew all I wanted was your happiness. Nothing could tear our dream world apart. And you found a new love and broke my heart. The moon won't glow like it glowed that night. That night when I held you, darling, oh, so tight. We two together, you said it would be. Then you lied.
You lied.
You turned. And walked out on me. On me. Thank you. Again, from a recent album, in fact, it's the title song. This is the original version of a song called Back on the Streets of the Bronx, which was, of course, used in the film A Bronx Tale. Our friend Chaz Palminteri needed a good song, and this is the original version. This is what we came up with.
Wop wop, shooty wop wop.
On the streets of the Bronx is where I wanna be. Standing on the corner singing good old harmony. I will be waiting for the man to come along and discover me. My father preach his son, please get a job. Oh, but I don't want to work, I want to be a singing star. Drive up and down the Bronx in my brand new shiny car. And on the streets, that's where I want to be. And on the streets, that's where I want to be. And on the streets of the Bronx, where I want to be. Standing on the corner singing good old harmony. I will be waiting for the man to come along and discover me. On the streets of the Bronx,
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 out on the streets of the Bronx,
on the streets of the Bronx,
out on the streets of the Bronx,
on the streets of the Bronx,
streets of the Bronx is where I wanna be.
All right, I guess we're on the air, I don't know. Where you go? You eat hot dogs again, right?
Everybody's enjoying some great hot dogs.
Hey, how about it? These hot dogs are really good. And we got berries in my wife's hot dogs there. They're going to love these things.
And I'll tell you, if you're looking to have a party, a private party, you don't want to cook, right? It's a Sunday party. Super. I don't know if you're booked already for the Super Bowl or the playoffs, but if you want to do something like that, you know the Giants are looking to get in the playoffs, the Jets. So
right.
This area is really waiting for something to happen in football season. But that'd be cool if you don't want to do it yourself.
Oh, yeah, this is
give
great.
Give him a call. He'll cater the whole thing.
He's got three wagons, so he can go to different ones. He's not just tied to one. But look at these.
Send them out.
Where's our camera guys at? What are you eating again? I want to see if we can get a close-up of these hot dogs here before we pass them around. Now, do we deliver? We got hot dogs here. These are great, man. That was really good sauce, bud.
If you just smell that, unbelievable.
Oh, man.
Really fantastic.
And we're looking, if we can set up a hot dog tour out in the Poconos area, this is going to be the first stop.
Well, yeah.
These guys. Unbelievable.
Yeah, he said he could do it. He could set it up someplace. And not only that, one of our trips, we could actually stop the whole bus, get off and have a hot dog.
Well, we can set that up. Definitely.
Yeah. Maybe not this time, but in the future. I think that would probably work really good and surprise everybody. They wouldn't even know.
We wouldn't even tell them. We wouldn't tell them in advance.
These are great, and he's right. He makes really good chili, and I love Texas Wiener.
It really is some of the best chili that I've tasted.
Yeah. I usually, you know what I do, too? I usually put mustard underneath,
yep,
and then the sauce on top, too.
That's the way I do it, but you can see the Texas Wiener here fails to compare with the Pocono hot dog.
Oh, yeah.
See,
everything's
big in Texas, but I don't know. Poconos seem to be a lot bigger.
Everything's big in the Poconos.
Well, Timmy's from Texas, so we'll have to ask him later, because I don't know. He's in the back. He's hiding someplace.
He's shouting.
So I'd like to thank you for coming on down.
You're welcome.
And we're
going to
go. We're going to go over and finish the show up. You want to come with us?
Sure.
Yeah, come on over. We're going to go over to see the snake man over here. Got your glove, Benzee?
All right.
We got to bring the mic with us, I guess. Let me grab that mic. Or we won't hear a thing you're saying. This is showbiz. Here you go. Here, you can slide right in.
Live TV. Yeah, you want it.
And now the venoms are coming out.
These are venomous
right up in here.
Oh, wait. All right.
Yeah, these are actually venomless snakes. They aren't venomoids, which means they do have their venom.
In other words, your gloves are worthless with these, baby.
Pretty much, yeah. If they bite you, they'll go right through those little gloves.
Is there one of those wine-drinking mouses there? Those beetle mouse? What is that?
But here we got...
Here we got something.
Trans-Pecos copperhead.
Wow,
we're going to throw him right in that tank.
I'm not getting near that tank.
Well, I throw him in there first.
10 feet.
This guy here, actually, I put the gloves on and I can handle this guy. He's a little bitey sometimes, but he's not too bad.
A little bitey sometimes.
Up here in New York, we do have copperheads. Copperheads aren't really considered a deadly snake, but they'll
mess you up.
They'll mess you up. You'll wish you wouldn't have played with them. As you can see here, he took a nice little strike at me there.
You're looking to get a new hostess?
There goes Hank.
You don't want to get rid of me yet, do you?
Copperheads, though, are very aggressive snakes. They're usually quick to bite and then figure out why they bit you. They really don't care.
Yeah, they don't care.
Up here in New York, though, we usually have a lot of people confuse our copperheads with our local milk snakes. I get calls all the time to come out because you got a rattlesnake or a copperhead, and it's usually a poor little eastern milk snake that's taking a rap for these guys. But again, these guys are very quick to strike. If you'll notice, they have triangular-shaped heads, and there's no marking on his head whatsoever where he gets his name copperhead from.
Good luck. Get him in there.
He's actually the nice one of the group here.
I bet you can see this kind of stuff when you're out there with the hot dogs.
Now we can usually put them in a brine and some vinegar and stuff like that.
Oh, you should have been with them guys out there just shot all them animals.
Oh, in Ohio?
For no reason. I got my own beliefs on that one.
This guy here is called a sharp-nosed viper.
I never know you could use them to totes for that. Look at this little thing. I bet this one's poisonous too.
Oh yeah, this one's very poisonous. I was just talking to the gentleman here. Said he was in Vietnam. And I always heard about this snake. Everybody kept talking about this mythical snake called a three-step. If you get bit, you'll take more than 3 steps before you fall over and die. I Googled it, I researched it, I could never find this snake. Well, I bought this snake, he's called a sharp-nosed snake. When I looked him up, I found out here's your three-pacer. He's called a three-pacer, a 100-pacer, or a Chinese moccasin. He's very deadly, but they don't get that big. See, most people associate venomous snakes as being very large and very deadly.
Sure.
A lot of your very venomous snakes are very small snakes.
So if you get bit, Tim,
if you get
three
bit,
words out, you know, three words of rap out. Holy God.
It doesn't matter if it's a big snake or a small snake. If it's got the venom, that's it, right?
Right, and these guys are pit vipers as well, meaning he also seeks you out by your body heat. So usually when they're in a tank like this, because they can't sense your body heat through the glass, they normally won't strike at you at the glass. Pick him up high enough where he can sense your body heat.
Back to something.
And then we'll go right after you. Yeah, thankfully, my wife tolerates my venomous snakes. She's not a fan of them, but she does put up with them.
She hides your beer in there, doesn't she?
I have the most important job.
Yeah, I thought they were for beer. I don't know.
No, this is to keep people away from your beer.
Right.
You know, you put two coolers out, one too. Full of snakes and one full of beer, and, you know, it's a roulette game.
Put a six-pack in there and put the snake on top of the six-pack. Nobody's bothering you.
You want to have a bottle of three-step? Go get it. Yeah.
Now, this snake here, he's called a jumping viper. And he's also a pit viper.
I don't jump anymore.
Oh, wow.
And the jumping viper, you can look at his coloration. It's very beautiful.
He'll
but the reason, he's called a jumping viper is because snakes actually cannot jump. This guy strikes so hard that when he strikes forward, it yanks the rest of his body off the ground after it.
That sounds like good news. I'll see you, boys.
And when he latches on, most venomous snakes are the kind that will hit and release, and they sit back and they watch and they wait for the prey to die. And a lot of people think that they actually track their prey by the prey smell. They don't. They actually track their own venom. Because where they attack something, it may have a lot of different rodents or something going through that area. So if they try to follow a rodent smell, they may not find what they attack. So they actually track their own venom, and they'll locate where they're at.
What do you do for holidays? Your house must get wild sometimes.
Well, you know, I mean, holidays are coming up.
I got wrapped around a Christmas tree.
Hey, Christmas presents, anniversary presents, Christmas presents, you know, birthday presents.
Are they kept in big...
Yes, they are.
Tanks like this?
Yes.
Pretty much.
And they're all in tanks that have physically locks on them. They're all labeled for what's inside of them and everything.
Oh, brother.
Because I've been bit once by a rattlesnake, and trust me, you learn really quickly.
Get your leaping little fella out of here. Our leaping days are over.
There you go.
Okay, now so far these are the nicer of the ones we have. If you want to grab that one.
Have a great hot dog.
These are the nice ones.
These are the nicer ones. This here is what a lot of people will come to me who like to fish, and they swear there's water moccasins up here. There are no water moccasins. We just have water snakes. And the water snakes we have, though, are extremely aggressive snakes.
Got a big padlock.
There's a big lock.
Bigger lock on this one.
You see that?
Yeah. Now this guy is very serious about biting you.
Okay.
He will bite through the glass or try to.
As long as it's closed, I can, you know.
And as he does that, he usually leaves venom streaks on the glass.
Okay.
He's serious. There he goes. If you would have saw that, he struck straight up at me right now. My wife will grab my tubes over there.
We got 911 ready.
Well, you told me, you know, to take care of him.
I told you to get him there.
Yeah, to get him, so. All right, now if we can just release the paper towel here.
This one here looks like he's wicked.
Yeah, this guy looks
wicked. He is wicked. Now, what we're going to do with this guy...
He looks like a happy guy.
...is we're actually going to milk him. But the first thing we do in order to get him is we're going to put him in a tube.
You're going to milk him. I ain't milking
him. Milk him.
Well, somebody's going to have to help me.
That's another story.
Okay, we're going to get this guy in a tube.
Good luck.
These are called restraining tubes. Yeah, well, he gives up pretty easily. One of the things...
Yeah, he looks it.
Oh, yeah, he's giving up.
Harry, there's a typical cottonmouth. That's where they get their name from. Look at the white in the mouth. That's his typical little tail rattling going. Okay. Now, my wife, right away, she says, don't be messing with him. He's mad. Actually, the madder he gets, the easier he is to handle. Because I know what he's going to do.
Good luck.
If he's just sitting back there all coiled up, I got no clue what he's going to do. So we're going to sneak him in a tube here.
I hope he don't crawl fast.
Sometimes he does, but I've gotten to learn to be a little quicker than he is, and a lot of patience, too.
Yeah, you're getting older. That quickness leaves.
A little patience there. Once he gets up in the tube, you grab him. Now I need a smaller tube, just a little bit smaller than the one I have here, because this is too long to get him all
now
the way
kids,
through.
Now, kids, don't order this for Christmas. Yeah. You can't build nothing
for only three easy payments of $19.99, get Jerry the Snake Man tubes.
It worked
P.O. Box 666, Pine Bush, New York.
Well, actually, if Rubbermaid knew what we did with their containers... most everybody I know who deals with snakes.
Do you have a license for all your...
Oh, yes. We are licensed by the DEC. We actually have three different licenses. We have one to keep the venomous. Believe it or not, in New York State, if you want to keep any snake that is native to your state, even a garter snake, you have to get a license for it. One more size up. You have to get a license for it. And for anything that's threatened or endangered. So we actually at the time, I guess it is a smaller one, we actually at the time have a license of all three.
That seems like a lot to go for.
So we can do it. Here we go.
You ever play with this kind of snake?
Now, he also likes to go to the bathroom. If you look in the tank here.
I can smell him.
He's, yeah.
And that's the other thing, too. The some people say that the copperheads smell like cucumbers. They do have a musk. I don't really think it smells like cucumbers.
I'll switch that head out of
that. Oh, no. See, this where is what we do.
I don't know. Over there. I'm going to Kilimanjaro myself now.
See, no, actually, I thought this would be a very unique thing to give me in a paper if I robbed the bank with this. I mean, who's going to stop me if I walk into the bank with the snake hanging out there?
No, I wouldn't hire her. The money.
There you go.
Make some sausages.
Okay, so what we're going to do is now...
Make some sausages with these things.
Yeah, don't put your head down there, Benzie.
As you can see, he's got his mouth open. He's ready. He knows what he wants to do or what he's got to do. So he's going to bite right onto that jar if I get him a chance, pulling back just a little bit more.
Brother.
We'll get him in there.
By the way, the hot dogs was good, but
here he goes.
Oh!
Now, see that venom?
Yeah.
Now, that venom there, he put in by himself. If he latches on and I push down, see if we can get him to really latch on there. If he can latch on and I push on his venom glands.
Do you get the venom to hospitals and stuff, or you don't do that?
There he goes. Now we push down.
Look at that.
Push on his venom glands. Wow. In order to use the venom, it has to be done in a scientific, like laboratory type of deal, right. Sterilized. Then they freeze dry it right away.
Want to take them home with you, Barry?
That's all right.
So the venom we have right here is probably enough to kill probably everybody in this room.
Wow.
You're first, man.
It only takes one little drop of venom.
Throw it out.
these guys, like I said, they're very quick to attack and very quick to strike at you.
For some people.
We can always find someone that venom would be good for, right?
Yeah.
The only problem is the venom, once it's out of the snake, doesn't last very long as far as potency goes.
Good luck.
So you'd have to use it right now. Now we slide this out here, get him back in his little container.
Well, you did that pretty quick.
That was good.
Hank.
I pay. Bit once, you learn. Now the last snake we got for you today, unless you want a few more, is we got our big guy.
Well, burn the big one up. That'd be plenty of time. We got time for the big one.
Okay. And the big one we will need some help with because he's...
All right, Tim. Anybody out?
No.
Rick.
Open the door.